Hello guys! Today we will talk about Notion. I will show you how I use Notion for creative projects and work-related stuff. As you probably know, Notion is a note-taking app and I've been using it for around 1.5 years now for my language teaching. I'm working as a language teacher. Besides that, I'm using it to capture and organize my ideas, but also I'm using it for creative projects as for this YouTube channel. Notion helped me to save a lot of time, work more efficient and gain clarity as I can outsource my thoughts into the system. Today we will dive right into the juicy advanced stuff as I'm assuming that you already know the basics of how to use Notion, and I will show you how I use Notion as a teacher. I show you how I work with databases, how I use different tools and functions to make my life much easier. By the way, my name is Yves, I'm from Germany, and on this channel I talk about the creative process and the struggle you face when you have to ship creative work. Before Notion, my approach was very amateurish. There are two tasks that are important for me if we talk about note-taking and organization. And the two main tasks are capturing ideas but also organizing my lessons. Before Notion, note-taking looked like that. I captured ideas, for example, if I read a book and I found something of interest, I wrote it down on index card, and then I was collecting index cards, and that's kind of stupid in this time and age. If we talk about lessons, I tried Evernote, I tried Google Calendar, I tried post-it notes, whiteboards, but at some point I ran into issues, into big problems. Let me explain. When I make my weekly schedule, I have to decide which topics I will cover with which student. And at the beginning, it's all fine, it's easy to manage, but at some point I run into issues. I run into issues because I have long-term students. I have a couple of students with whom I already had close to 200 lessons. That means that I covered with them 200 topics. And before a lesson, I have to decide, can I use already existing topics or do I have to create a topic from scratch? What would take me around 4 hours for a topic? So it makes a lot of sense to save time and use an existing topic. But to figure that out, back then I was going into my Skype chat and eliminating the options, and it took me around 10 to 15 minutes per lesson, and it was just super stupid, and I figured out that I have to put a system in place to stop that madness. Alright guys, switching to screen mode. Here, a quick overview of how my Notion setup looks like. I have many different departments. Here in the project department, I collect ideas or work on some creative projects. I have this YouTube department. In this department, I have two sections. I collect ideas and have some general notes. I have a teaching department where I manage all my language teaching. And here are three sections. I have the section ideas. I have a database for topics and students, and I have my weekly planning database. Today we want to talk about the section teaching. I made a duplication of the section here in the yellow area so that I don't share any personal information of my students. Let's start with the ideas section. Let's assume an idea pops up. For example, storytelling. I had the idea that I want to talk about storytelling with my students, and here I made the note. Next, let's say I have a topic idea being too nice. I write it down here. I have an idea to talk about sapiens, but for example, history, the history of humankind. I have a couple of other ideas. Let's say today is the 28th, so they get sorted by date. Here I can make some notes. I can say meaning of life. I want to cover the perspective of Viktor Frankl. Then I have history of humankind. I would like to cover Yuval Noah Harari's book. Next, I would like to give the different things priorities. With second best priority is Sapiens. Then I would like to talk at some day about the meaning of life. I would maybe cover at some point Nietzsche as well. And then the Joe Rogan controversy is already too late. It's already done. So it has low priority. And then I have storytelling. telling, yeah, sounds good. Let's say I'm starting a research project. I'm trying to find articles and I'm making a new topic to talk about with my students. I mark it in status research and I could add some articles and source materials. For example, I found here an article from Yuval Noah Harari about sapiens, and it's from SWR, and I just added here, it's from 2022. Yeah, I'm pretty much done here. There's an article from Yuval Noah Harari as well. It's about the meaning of life. It's from Zeit. I add the date, and let's say I'm done with my research because I have 20 sources or whatever. Now I could mark it as done. And what happens? This project doesn't show here anymore. Why? Because I have a couple of filters and two rules implemented. The rules, I don't want that tags with not now or done are shown here in this overview. That comes in very handy as you can always keep it very clean and tidy. Let's have a look at this database. This database is very handy. It helps me to keep an overview about the topics I already covered. I have tags that I'm using here, and the tags represent students that I talked about this topic already. As you see, I changed the original names of my students into Harry Potter character names. And what can be handy as well is the different data views. I use consumption table most of the time. You can also use calendar, you can use gallery format and see it like that. Or you can use view all. That can also be very handy and useful. Now I had the ideas, I had the database, and now I have here a overview and an integrated database of everything here. For example, is my weekly planning. It comes from here. And let's say I have a Monday, I have three students, and I'm planning my week. To do so, I go into this database that I have here, and I will check what topic is covered and what not. To do that, I could open this filter tag and, for example, select Lucius Malfoy, and it shows me what is available. Let's say I can talk with him about being too nice. Yeah, I can do that. Here, Fred Weasley, I know I have a new topic. It's called Sapiens, and I will cover that with him. Granger, I would talk about Nietzsche. And let's say Harry Potter, I already have a topic. The interesting thing here, I can use multiple filters as well. For example, I have a group teaching, then I add a couple of other names as well, and it shows me what is not covered yet. Again, here are topics I can use now, for example, storytelling. It helps me a lot to stay productive. Are there any alternatives, you may ask? Yes, I like how you think. So basically there are alternatives. In my case, I would like to stick with the setup for a while now because there are costs of switching involved and I built this setup for one and a half years. Good alternatives could be Obsidian and Rome Research. In the part-time YouTube Academy, I met Nicole. Nicole became a friend. She has a fantastic channel about note-taking, and I learned a lot about Obsidian and other note-taking apps. Basically, I would say Obsidian looks very promising, and over the long run, I would like to give it a try. The only thing I don't like too much is the visual aesthetic of Obsidian. It looks a bit tacky and has not that polished and finished look like you have it on Notion. But besides that, Obsidian has a strong community behind it, many plugins that you could use, and you can personalize it to your own needs. Just a quick note on the side, there are fundamental differences between Obsidian and Notion. Notion has this top-to-bottom approach. It's structured in a hierarchical way. At the beginning, you have to figure out how your data will be structured over the long run. So you have basically less flexibility, I would say. In Obsidian, it's completely different. You have a network of interconnected data or ideas, and it's actually kind of structured like your brain. Alright guys, let's sum it up. So basically, I like to use Notion, it's fun, I like the aesthetic of it, it saved me a lot of time and energy. Check it out, maybe it can help you as well. Here are a couple of last words. Stay organized.